Hey everyone, welcome. Today we got an exciting one. It is Friday, finally excited. But today we have the predictions for the Prime card. We're going to start off with SX versus DTG. Who do I think is going to win? How do I think they're going to win? And what can we expect from this fight? Now, from pad footage from SX, we've only seen a little bit of SX, nothing much, no promotion from either guy. That's what I kind of hate about this scene at the minute, is that no one's promoting or doing anything. So I'm not exactly sure. I have got some bets on. Now, I will admit, I've got some bets on. If you are gambling, please gamble responsibly. This video is not sponsored by anyone or anything. But if you are gambling, gamble responsibly. I am an unresponsible gambler. That is a joke. I know I sound very serious, but yeah. SX is one of them. If you go to House of Boxing, I believe it's called, by Boxing Social or something, you can put on bets to win money, but it's not our real money. So you put on little credit bets, and you have a chance of winning some money. Now, I have put on a real bet for some of these fights, and I'll get to them later. But right now, we're at SX versus DTG, and I believe SX comes out on top. I don't remember what I predicted. I think it's decision. DTG, don't believe he's won any of his fights. He's already fought before. SX hasn't fought before. SX looks all right. SX, I don't know if he's in shape or not. Didn't take his shot off at the weigh-ins. The weigh-ins are finished about 40 minutes ago. And yeah, I have no idea. Then we've got Ashley Webb versus Alexia Grace. Now, Alexia Grace versus Ashley Webb was meant to happen a few months ago. A long while ago. And I predicted Ashley Webb was going to win. And I still, to this day, predict Ashley Webb wins via knockout in round 2 or 3. Chase Diamore versus Temple Arts once again. I believe Chase Diamore wins. I think I put decision for this one because I don't know if Chase Diamore has power, really. Temple Arts, I can't remember when he fought. I can't remember who he fought, and I can't remember how he did. So I've given it to Chase. I just think Chase is finally coming off of his third loss, and I believe he's going to get a win. Ed Matthews versus Swarms. This is a recent card added. This is why we're to wait till last minute, just in case anything gets added or removed. There is a card that I will predict that hasn't been announced, but could be announced. Or it could be announced on a future card. But next up is Ed Matthews versus Swarms. This one's difficult. Ryan Taylor versus Swarms. I was giving it to Swarms via decision. I just think Swarms wins this one as well. But I do believe this one will be via decision as well. No disrespect to Swarms or Ed Matthews. But Ed Matthews hasn't trained for this fight or got ready for this fight at all in the slightest. And Swarms was training for someone else. And Ed Matthews, I think, fights differently. And I think it's going to be a very different fight. Next up, we've got Nick Lamau and Alex Wasabi versus Luis Alcaraz, Pineda, and B. Dave. Now, on the weigh-ins, they did Winderson Nunes first, I think. But according to this one, Nick Lamau and Alex Wasabi is first. I do believe Nick Lamau and Alex Wasabi win. I think they beat Pineda and B. Dave. Via knockout, nah, it'll be a decision. Nick Lamau couldn't knock out B. Dave in the survivor tag. B. Dave couldn't beat Nick Lamau. Nick Lamau won the whole survivor tag. Pineda, pro boxer, he's good, but I just feel like Alex Wasabi and Nick Lamau might be a bit too much for them this time, and I think they win the title. I have a feeling that this could be the best duo in influencer boxing. If you recognize what I'm saying, it's because I've actually mentioned this in my last video in the best duo ever, and that's who I believe will win and get the championship title. Next up is Winderson Nunes Batista versus my mate Nate. I have Winderson Nunes winning by a knockout in round 2 or 3, or it was like 3 or 4. I think they're going 4 rounds, but yeah, I'd say round 2 or 3 if that's the correct thing on the thing. But yeah, I believe he just wins by knockout. Now we're on to my real bets. We are on to my real bets. The ones that got me, that are going to get me money, I hope. King Kenny versus Anthony Taylor, like I said, it depends on what kind of fight this is. If Anthony Taylor's going to come in and dirty box and Kenny can't deal with that, then AT wins. If Kenny deals with it, Kenny wins. And that is a check on my money, which means I believe that Kenny wins. Then we have Dean the Gray versus Wiley Sharks. We've seen this all before. We have seen this fight before. I didn't get to bet on a round with these guys, with the next two and the Kenny one. But the Logan Paul and KSI one, I got to put actual like rounds and all that on it. But I say Wiley Sharks wins. But personally, I believe Wiley Sharks wins by knockout, because Dean the Gray just doesn't really have a chin. He's been put down two times by Wiley Sharks, and I believe Wiley Sharks does it again. The only reason why Dean the Gray won last time is because Wiley Sharks turned around, had nothing to do in the knockdown. It's strictly the fact that he turned around, which was kind of because of the knockdown, but yeah. So I guess it was kind of a knockdown. I'm waffling. This video is just to waffle. Then we've got Salt Papi versus Slim. I like both guys. I hate that this fight is here, but I just feel that Slim is so awkward. He's so tall, such a long range. He does hit hard. Salt Papi hits hard too. But I just feel that Slim, I don't know, I just feel Slim beats him. I just feel that Slim overpowers him in this fight. I can't wait to be wrong. If I lose the money, I don't really care. This card is so entertaining and so amazing. It's insane. It's so good. It's such a good card. Then we got Logan Paul versus Dylan Danis. Guys, if you really think Dylan Danis is going to win, there's something wrong. Dylan Danis does not win. It doesn't matter how. I bet Logan Paul wins by knockout. Didn't predict a round or anything. I just think Logan Paul wins by knockout. But if we go on my home of boxing, I won't show it, just in case. If we go on my home of boxing, I actually predicted that Logan Paul wins via round 3 and 4 by knockout. And then finally, this one, KSI versus Tommy Fury. Who wins? Who is the Misfits champion? Who owns Misfits? Well, this Saturday we're going to find out. Tomorrow, over 24 hours now. It's under 24 hours for most of these fights, but in over 24 hours, we will find out who is meant to be the king of Misfits. And I have predicted it will be KSI via knockout. If JJ wins via decision, he's beat Tommy Fury at boxing. He's beat the boxer. He beat a boxer at boxing. He beat him at his own game. But I believe KSI wins by knockout. He's powerful. We don't really know where Tommy ranks. The only person he's beat is Jake Paul, and he couldn't drop Jake. He struggled against Jake. I believe KSI is better than Jake. I do believe that. I believe KSI puts his whole all into it. Jake puts his whole all into it as well. But you can just see the levels. You know, the MMA guys, the UFC guys, they've all learned how to strike. None of them have learned how to box. And when they have learned how to box, it's not great. Nate Robinson doesn't know how to box. He's a basketball NBA player. Deji, he was terrible. I just feel like KSI beats him. Like, if you go through all of Jake's opponents, I'd say KSI beats all of them. And I'd say by knockout as well. Will it be quicker? I don't know. I cannot really go, oh my god, yeah. But Tommy Fury is overlooking KSI, in my opinion. He's going, oh, you're not Jake Paul. It's all coming down to Jake Paul. KSI needs to stop. He needs to stop focusing on trying to beat Jake Paul. And Tommy Fury needs to stop pretending KSI is worse. It's the delusion. If you're going, oh, my next opponent is going to be worse than my other opponent, you're fighting the wrong opponent, you idiot. Find someone better. Find someone like Vidal Riley. We know you won't. We all know you won't fight Vidal. But either fight, like, you're saying KSI is worse than Jake. You should be fighting someone better than Jake then. Why are you fighting KSI? You want to be a world champion. You ain't fighting no one on a world champion level, bro. Just watch yourself there. And KSI, don't worry about being better than Jake. If you beat Tommy Fury, yes, you're better than Jake. But it's how you beat him. If you beat him by knockout, well done. But if you outbox him, you could outbox Jake. You can knock out Jake. So who do I have? I have KSI via knockout. No predictive rounds. I just think KSI knocks him out. That's it. That's all I got. I haven't got anything else to say. their fists will finally do the talking, and we'll find out. Now, the last fight I want to talk about is Idris Virgo versus Mike Perry. The reason why I want to talk about this fight is because they had a face-off at the, at the weigh-ins, at the end, right at the end. If you stayed right till the end, you see that those two face off. Those two really want to fight. Now, that will either be on this card or it'll be on another card. Idris Virgo's fought recently, so it might not happen. But you never know, Mams Taylor might just pull a sneaky one and put it in. But who do I believe wins that? I think Mike Perry wins that one. How does Mike Perry get it done? I'm going to say decision. I think Mike Perry gets it done by decision. But that's all I got. Hope you guys enjoyed. And I will see you tomorrow. But let me know who you think wins. Let me know where I'm wrong. Let me know how you think they win. And yeah, I'll catch you in a bit. Peace out, everyone.